Back in Syria, the fighting had zeroed in on Aleppo, one of the great cities of the world, where fierce resistance had erupted. It became clear that the Syrian regime, aided by Russian air power, was deliberately targeting hospitals. With Red Crosses emblazoned across their roofs, hospitals could not possibly be mistaken for military targets. There could be no doubt that war crimes were being committed, and committed with impunity. The low level of international support for the internally displaced was compounded by British anti-terrorism legislation, making it difficult to send money and supplies to areas of deepest need within Syria. As Aleppo was pounded back to the Stone Age, a British doctor, David Knott, was operating in one of the hospitals targeted by the regime. As the sirens sounded the alarm for yet another attack, David was urged to take cover. But he was operating on a small child who would die if he left in mid-operation. Exhausted and fatalistic, David refused, and with the anaesthetist continued with the operation. The hospital was hit, but they and the baby survived. When David returned from Aleppo, he was invited to lunch with the Queen. He told the story on Desert Island Discs in one of that programme's most memorable episodes in more than 70 years. David Knott has acted ever since to prick the international conscience of the world over Syria. He certainly pricked mine. His evidence enabled me to persuade the Speaker of the House of Commons to grant, most unusually, an emergency debate on what was happening in Syria, which then took precedence over all government business. After the 2015 election, Joe Cox, who had just been elected to the House of Commons, came to see me to ask whether we could team up to run a new all-party group, Friends of Syria, and I readily agreed. We worked closely together until Joe was murdered in 2016. She was a bundle of energy and determination, and I adored her.